peaceful in this dark surrounding. Nothing is moving, nothing can be seen, and nothing can be heard. There is no breeze or touch of dew. I found an unfathomable way to this nothingness. Something is. Before anything, something is happening. Ever so gently within this stirring darkness, a silent sound approaches a sightless vision. All past, present, and future fade in silhouette that's coming. The sound and vision fuse together as the darkness thunders and plunges into the crevices of a radiant orb, rising from the obscure depths with a mighty awakening.
This is how much. He was given the right to be. He was given the light from the universe. He was given the sight to see. He was given free life from the universe. He was given it all his way. Jason is born today. Jason is born today. Good morning, Dad. I know what time it is. Yes, I'm dressed. I ate breakfast. Steak and eggs. Dad, I'm eating fine. I feel great, honest. I know you are. Dad, the job is not that bad. The money's okay.
Besides, I'm not going to be a laborer all my life.
Yes, most of the guys are younger than me. What's that got? I know how old I am, Dad. I'm 56. No, Dad, no, I'm kidding. Dad, it's too early in the morning to panic about my life. Let me be 25 for a while. Dad. Dad. Yes. Dad, can we panic over dinner? I'll even panic over lunch, but before breakfast, it's it.
Dad, I did eat breakfast.
I mean, I don't want to panic before your breakfast. Dad, let's end the did you eat breakfast thing. Okay, how is my music coming along? Fine, I play once in a while.
That's right, it's a hobby. I know my priorities. I said I only play occasionally anymore. I'm a working man now. Dream is over. Yes, I know you're not being sarcastic.
I know you're not telling me to give it up altogether, just for the time being. And I have.
Who? Mr. Johnson, your supervisor?
And you at 9:30. Dad, we've been through this. I don't know anything about computers.
I don't know. Let me think about it.
I just have to think about it.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, I'll be there. Dad, my ride is here. Because my car broke down.
The transmission is...
When I save some money, I'll fix it. Dad, let's not discuss my financial status right now. No, Miles is not driving me to work. I know you don't like him. Another guy. John.
Dad, I only see Miles at work. I don't drink with him.
I don't know if he's on drugs.
Dad, I told you, I don't hang around with Miles. Take care. Goodbye.
Come on in, Miles.
So, what'll it be today? Hong Kong, Australia, the Virgin Islands?
Now, let's go somewhere where we can breathe in the fumes, lift heavy objects, and say F words all day.
I thought we went there yesterday.
Yeah, but it was so much fun, I want to go again.
Well, F and A and bon voyage, then. Health kick today, huh, Jay?
Yeah, and this time I'm sticking to it. From this day forward, let the gods be told that Jason Miller begins a new life, a new beginning. A mucusless diet of rational fasting, whole foods, and the juice from the golden essence of life.
I feel the life force travel through my veins. My vision sharpens. Every cell of my being is alive. I'm alive.
Amen.
Hey, sunflower seeds, will ya?
From the universe. New song, Jace?
Yeah.
Another fine meal last night, eh?
I got a little hungry after dinner.
And I got the runs. Why would I have the runs?
Oh, you got me there, Jace.
Yeah.
Why don't you drink a little of this, though? It'll kill whatever's growing down there.
No, thanks. I'd rather drink this and have the runs. I feel life with every burning sensation that transcends through my bowels.
Sick man, Jeez. Real sick. It's a nice shot. Lori, what'd you get?
Oh, she gave it to me the other night.
She's still in school?
Yeah, well, she's
Student teaching at the elementary school.
How do you guys get along?
You know, on and off.
Any good fights lately?
No, just the same one. Last night was a rerun. What would you declare this place a federal disaster area?
I have no idea why I should do something like that.
I told her I'm a songwriter. We're supposed to be messy. Songwriters are judged by the mess they leave.
You're Beethoven, then. I don't know how you do it, Jace.
Do what?
Start down 4 or 5 bars of Snickers, a quart of half and half, and all in one sitting.
Well, anyway, I think it's over between us. I don't know why you put up with me anyway.
Despite lacking any kind of direction or discipline in your life, I can think of a lot of reasons why
you're a riot, not a real riot.
So who's this here? That's a cool looking dude.
That's my grandfather. I found a picture of him in the parents' attic.
Your dad's father?
Yeah. Mom told me once he was a lot like me.
Yeah, like what ways?
Well, he played the guitar. He wrote folk songs. But I've never seen any of his stuff. And he was a dreamer till the day he died. Couldn't settle for the normal things. One more.
What about your dad?
What about him?
Well, I mean, he was his son. Did your dad say anything about it?
Just the fact that he drank too much, his dreams were too big, and he never added up too much in his life. Mom saw him differently. I think she liked him. God, I wish I could have met him.
From the universe. Tales from the land of the French mushroom. Is this another Jason creation?
Yeah.
What about this?
Oh, that's a sculpture of mushroom land.
Tell me about it.
Mushroom Land is the place where, all dreams are real and all reality, dreams come true. Evil's only known just to remind us how wonderful the spirit of life really is. Mushroom Land is a place where, your mind is as fast as the universe and all obstacles are non-existent. I've known about it all my life. Still a million miles away.
Well, what are you going to do with the story?
I've always wanted to tell it in song on the side of a mountain with my band, a 100-piece orchestra, and a choral group 500 strong. Someday, I can just
do it. Do it.
It's funny, I haven't told this story to anyone in years. But you're different. I think you understand. Miles, can dreams be real?
Sure. You know, James, I never understood why you didn't make it pro ball. You've got all the qualities. Tall, good-looking, strong, confused, messy. That's all the ingredients it takes to be a Hall of Famer. I mean, look at all the greats that were just like you. Babe Ruth, Mickey Mantle, Jimmy Pearsall.
Wait a minute. Jimmy Pearsall was a nut.
Bingo.
Yeah, you're right. I love baseball. I'd trade all this to be in the World Series.
All this?
Good riffies.
Okay, base is loaded, bottom of the two out, white sock, hot one to nothing, Jason Miller at the mound, he looks into his catcher, shakes off a sign, then another, now he's ready, the windup, and the pitch is a ball.
Gracious building, takes the sign from the catcher, lines and fires, strike one,
ha ha, just building, the count goes to 1-1, Miller looks in again, rears, and throws, ball two. The fans are delirious. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Here's the next pitch from Miller, and it is a strike.
cut the tension with a chainsaw.
Let's fill it.
Tastes great.
Let's fill it.
Tastes great.
Let's fill it.
Okay.
The fans are holding on for dear life. Here's a 2-2 pitch by Miller. It is a curveball. Swung on long drive. Deep to right field. It's going. It's a long one. It's back. It's way back. But it's a foul ball. Why not?
Miles Sorensen calls timeout. He didn't like what he saw on that last pitch.
Jason, I hate this guy.
What? Give him a fastball high and away.
He wears glasses and gets glare on the top part. Smoke him high, Jason. Smoke him high.
Well, there was Sorensen's head sure put a determined look on Miller's face. Here's the full count pitch to Reggie Jackson. This is his favorite situation. He gets in and sneers. Miller rears and throws. Fastball swung on him. Miss striking out the way.
Join the clubhouse celebration. We're talking to Miles Sorensen, who caught a great game. What's going through your mind right now, Miles?
Oh, excellent. ecstasy, Ben, just ecstasy. Why, we said back in February, if we stay healthy and do what we're supposed to, why, then we'll do what we're supposed to.
Do you enjoy the fact that this is your first championship?
Oh, you bet I do, Ben. Why, I'm right proud of these guys, all the way from the ice cream vendor right on up to the highest paid athlete on the team, and I'm proud to say that I am that person.
The ice cream vendor. So, tell me, Miley.
Go ahead. Green?
Can you do it again next year?
Oh, why, sure we can. Why, if we stay healthy and do what we're supposed to, why, then we'll do what we're supposed to.
What do you have planned for the offseason, Miles?
Well, I think first I'm going to enjoy a little bit of this. Then I'm going to spend the rest of the winter
breathing diesel fumes and lifting heavy objects, because we're working men, huh, Miles?
Yeah, we are.
Yeah. Well,
come on, Jason, let's get at it.
Jason!
Anyway, I meant a different kind of difference.
know the way he stares through the sky sometimes, it's as though he's in someplace far, far away. He's always been like that, you know, since he was born. Sometimes I get the feeling that he's got some big dream that only he knows about. But a dream so big that only he hears it calling.
Oh, yeah? Well, I hope they're serving dinner wherever they're calling from. Out!
Good for
damn
you!
What'd you say?
Oh, sorry, honey. Let me see.
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yes.
What's the matter, Jim?
What's the matter? Why do you keep asking me questions? I had a dream once, didn't I? I wasn't a bad clarinet player.
You were wonderful.
Well, I wasn't wonderful.
Well, I said you were.
You know, I thought I'd play music forever. Band.
It was a great band.
You remember those nights at Florentino's? I'd play 1 o'clock jump 4 or 5 times a night. You know, I could play that tune in my sleep and still play better, couldn't
you? You and JoJo would lean back to back and sway to the music. Come on, let's give it a try.
No!
Come on!
For the stars someday, Jim. Just keep playing that pipe. Yeah, I reached for the stars, all right.
I wish he'd live to see Jason. They look so much alike, and he's so much like him.
That's where I want the resemblance to stop.
Jim,
now, Sue, I'm 37 years old. I want to enjoy my grandchildren before I'm dead or too old to take them places. No, Jason won't fail. He's the only dream I've got left, and the only dream is reality. My son's not going to wind up the same way his grandfather did, and I did. I want him to be somebody. I just want him to be somebody.
Getting to know one another.
Well, we do things together. Hey, we went for a ride, what, 2-3 weeks ago, didn't we? Had a good time?
That wasn't a ride. It was a company bruncheon. And it was more like 2 months ago.
Well, if you'd like me to quit my job, we can spend more time together. Yeah, that's it. Then we won't have to worry about the bills. We can spend the rest of our time getting to know each other living in a tent.
Well, now, that sounds like a pretty good idea to me.
What? What's the name of your planet, son?
Take a guess, Dad.
I don't know. Pluto?
No, guess again.
Neptune.
Nope. Guess again, Dad.
Oh, I give up. What is it?
Mushroom land.
Mushroom land? Take a look at that thing. Looks like a brain kind of.
That's what mushroom land is.
Well, what's so new about mushroom land if it's in everybody's head?
Because most people know it's there.
Hey, you've got a point there.
I've been there, Dad. It's a new place.
Oh, yeah? Does anybody else go there besides you?
I don't know. Have you been there?
Not recently.
You want to go?
Sure, let me get my keys.
No, Dad. I feel it. It's like it kind of swallows me. And I see things all around me, like I never saw before.
Hmm? Like what? What do you see?
It's hard to explain. Trees are greener. The sky is bluer. I see everything better. I feel like I'm inside what I see, not outside. I feel happy. Then a thought comes to my head.
Go on, what thought comes to your head?
That if you love the world and be friends with everything that grows on it, you'll always be happy. And mushroom will never go away. Dad, do you want to go to mushroom with me?
Yes. But we'll have to wait a few years before we go there.
Why?
Because I have to go to work tomorrow, and because I think your mushroom land is heaven, and I'm not quite ready for heaven, yes, sir.
Oh, Dad. You don't have to go to heaven to get to mushroom land. It can be right here. Right here in the house. Right now.
Well, there's no mushroom land for me. Not yet, anyway.
But, Dad, you can be there right now. And tomorrow. And forever.
Mm-hmm. Well, if mushroom land means getting up at 6 and rushing off to spend 8 hours at work, then I guess I've been in mushroom land for the last 20 years. No, Jason, unfortunately for me, your mushroom land will have to wait till another time. But until then, tomorrow, I go to work. You go to school, and that's reality land. And I know what that is. I guess you can do your homework tonight, son. Do me a favor. Next time you go to mushroom land, take your homework and do it there.
Yes, Dad.
You better start thinking about your schoolwork, son. It's for your own good. Mushroom land is not reality. It's only a dream. Come on, son. It's time for bed.
Dad?
Yes, son?
Can I dream to be real?
I wonder. I wonder what it's like beyond that star. I wonder what it's like to go that far. I wonder what it's like so far away. I wonder if I'll ever know someday.
Thank you. so big that it almost blew me over. A lot of people hated the wind, but I liked it too. What are you writing here, honey?
Oh, a song.
Oh my goodness. Another Grandpa Jason Miller in the family.
Did Grandpa write a lot of songs?
Yes, he did. Do you remember a song he used to sing to you when you were just a little boy?
I think so.
Well, your Grandpa wrote it for your dad when he was just a little boy. He's a little boy in his little world, and his big brown eyes see little miracles.
But
you very much. Oh, Jim, Jason has not come home from school yet.
You haven't heard from him at all?
Not a word. Nothing.
What about his classmates? Have they seen
him? I've called everyone in his class, and it's unlikely that he'd be with any of them this afternoon. Mrs. Moore told me that some of the children made fun of Jason today, and he was embarrassed.
Why?
He took his sculpture to school for show and tell. Jim, they laughed at him. Mrs. Moore said she had to break up a fight between Jason and another boy in the schoolyard. Where are you going?
I'm going to go look for him.
Oh, well, I'm going to come with you.
I know, in case he comes home.
Jason? Oh, Jason, where have you been? Honey, we've been worried sick.
It's after 6 o'clock and you didn't even call. What's wrong with you?
Mom? Dad? They made fun of me. They made fun of my sculpture and my story about mushroom.
That's it. Jason, you've got to stop telling me stories. I'll only get worse if he does. Son, you've got to stop spending so much time on your little fantasy. It doesn't make sense to the others. Now, you're setting yourself up for humiliation. People can be mean, especially if you alienate yourself from them for some crazy little story.
Jim.
No. Now, your grades could be better. You're not putting enough time in your schoolwork. And you don't even have any real friends.
Jim.
Sue, please. You're only 10 years old and you're already a loner. Now that's got to stop. No more mushroom wire.
But Dad,
I don't care what it is, son. It's for your own good. Now, you trust me, don't you?
Yeah, but you...
Now, Jason, having a dream is great. But it's only a dream. Now, mushroom land is not going to give you the things you need to make you happy. You need a good education if you're going to be somebody. You figure you want to have things that dreams can't buy.
But no. Dad!
Mushroom land is over with. It's for your own good. I want my son to be somebody.
I'll be somebody, Dad. I'll be somebody.
You're beginning to see some problems and never lose. Let's settle down. Everybody start by passing up yesterday's homework. Jason, did you do your homework?
Yes, I did it.
And where is it?
In Mushroom Land. Tell him, spaceman.
Shut up.
Quiet. Quiet. Jason, where's your homework?
It's at home. I forgot.
I told you that the next time this happens, your grades will be lowered.
Why? What's forgetting my homework have to do with grades, my ability to know this stuff?
Because I said so, that's why. And since when do you start questioning my ability as a teacher?
Well,
your parents and I have discussed this. And I've told you to bring your homework in when it's due. Not tomorrow, not next week, not next month, but now, today.
He's not here today, Mrs. Jensen. He's light years old.
Shut up!
And how do you say that in Mushroom Land language?
With my clip!
All right! Shh. Sit! You're looking at it, young man. Everybody pay attention. We're on chapter 10, square roots. I need a volunteer to come to the board and do the first problem. Jason Miller? Do the first one. The rest of you work on problems 2 through 20. I need them done by the end of the period.
I'll be there.
Oh my God.
Oh, great. 20 years ago. Screaming, steaming, yelling, howling since the days of rain. Baby boomers hammered hard rock, driving out the rain. Strong rebellion, raising hell in concerts far and wide. Protesting, arresting, questions, why our waters high? Plans got tighter, rock got harder, how those windows cried. Charging a bubble, serving the king, but hard rock never died.
Hey,
your songs exposed?
I couldn't believe it.
What about the others?
Oh, well, some replied, others didn't. Those that replied said, thank you very much for submitting your tape. Unfortunately, your song is not right for our artists at this time. Signed with a generic signature.
How many did you contact?
Oh, 3 or 4. Not enough, I guess.
You know, Jace, I know this dude that sold cemetery property.
Well, thanks for telling me that wonderful news, Miles. You know someone who sells cemetery property? What wonderful news!
Easy. Let me get the microphone.
Well, go on.
He tells me he sells graves for a door.
What has that got to do with my songs?
I didn't think. It takes him maybe not long, 50 doors to get one sale.
Oh, you mean maybe I should go door to door and sell my songs? Yeah, and at Christmas time, sell Jason Miller's Merry Christmas tape. Yeah, what a wonderful idea that I can send flyers around the neighborhood. Jason Miller's coming to town with his greatest hit on cassette. Don't forget to stock up when it comes to your door.
That's not a bad idea. What I meant, though, was if you go to 50 producers, you might find one who's crazy enough to believe in you. I mean, it's a numbers game, case. The more big shots you believe in, the sooner you find the one who believes in you.
Sometimes you scare me, Miles.
Why?
Why? I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. You know why you scare me? Because you're right.
To believe in your own thought. To believe that what is true for you in your private heart is true for all men. That is genius.
Did you write that?
If I did, I'd be famous. After I did, of course.
Who wrote it?
Ralph
Brandon?
Ralph Brandon. Can you imagine? You know something, Alice? My life is not for a spectacle. It is for itself. It is easy to live in the world after the world's opinion, and it is easy to live in solitude after our own. But the great man is he who, in the midst of the crowd, can maintain with perfect sweetness the independence of solitude. And how sweet it is.
Bravo, Ralph! Bravo! Come on, Miles, who wrote that?
Ralph Waldo Emerson.
Got any more?
I got a million of them. Here's my favorite. Nothing is at last sacred but the integrity of your own mind.
What's the name of that book?
Self-Reliance.
Self-Reliance. I like that. Self-Reliance. You like Christmas, Miles?
Sure. See, there are always, I forgot to open a little present that you want to open.
It's June. When are you going to open it?
Well, I guess when Christmas comes around again.
Why don't you open it?
I got plenty of sweaters to last me through the year.
I remember the first Christmas I slept 8 hours.
What's so unusual about that?
How can anyone sleep 8 hours with all those presents under the tree and that special spirit that kind of settles on the town like a whispering snowfall?
I don't know. A couple of bottles of this kind of spirit and I can sleep through a blizzard.
Yeah, but you know what I mean, don't you?
Sure. I get the same feeling every New Year's Eve when midnight's about to come around. I wish I was in every big city in the world. Times Square, State Street in Chicago, even the Johnny Cars.
Yeah, you got it. I mean, I was sad the first time I slept 8 hours. All that excitement was gone. I can't explain it. It's like, since then I've had this certain longing for something. I don't know, I've always felt there was so much more. But every time I get a glimpse, it slips away. I gotta get that spirit back, Miles. I wish it were Christmas every day.
Christmas is my favorite time of year. From November through the first day of the year, I got a feeling of joy to share with every girl and boy. Let's all sing out loud a happy Christmas cheer. Christmas is my favorite time of year. Let the snow fly, let it whisper in my ear. Merry Christmas, hear the call, peace on earth too.
sure. Hey, Jason, your dad's here.
Hey, Dad, come on in. Want something to drink?
No, I think you and Miles here have had my share already.
There's plenty of Miles. I don't think he wants anything to drink.
Did I talk to you alone?
I can talk with Miles here. I don't have any problem with that.
That's okay. I'd be going anyway. I'll see you at work, Chase.
See you later, Miles.
Jason, you know what today was?
Yes, the 5th.
What else?
It's Friday, the 5th. I forgot about the interview. Dad, I'm sorry.
No, don't apologize to me. It's your career, it's your loss, and I guess you want to be a laborer all your life. A nobody who spends his free time living like some bum on Skid Row. What the hell's the matter with you, son? You're 25 years old. When are you going to grow up and realize you can't get rich working hard labor?
It's not that bad, Dad.
Oh, it's not, eh? Oh, son, you're pissing your life away. Working 8 hours, coming home, drinking alcohol, and plunking on that banjo is not the way of becoming a successful person.
You like Christmas, Dad?
What in God's name are you asking me that for?
I was talking to Miles about when I lost the Christmas spirit. Wondered if you had anything to do with it.
You're drunk.
I know.
I told Mr. Johnson that you're ill and that you'd see him on Monday.
Monday?
Yes, Monday.
I have to work Monday.
He'll be in his office till 7. He said he'd see you then.
Wonderful.
Oh, Jason, I don't know how many times I told you can't live on dreams. That a good job is going to shape your life into a more comfortable future.
Maybe I don't want to be comfortable, Dad. Dad, did you see the phone tonight?
What are you talking about? I don't have to listen to this bullshit.
Full moons aren't bullshit, Dad. Dad, you never talk about when you used to play in a band. I've never even heard you play that my first day. I used to watch you sitting and reading the paper and wonder what's on your mind. You never seem to tell me.
That's because I only told you what's good for you. What I think doesn't matter. But it's time you started thinking about your future.
Okay. I'll see Mr. Johnson Monday after work.
For your own good,
sir. I know.
Watched you long enough doing nothing with your life. That music didn't take you anywhere but down. Now don't wind up the same way your grandfather did.
Why don't you ever talk about Grandpa, Dad?
What I've told you about.
Yeah, but nothing good. Was he a good singer?
He was a fine
singer. Where are all of his songs?
I don't know. They're someplace. But let's talk about Monday.
No, let's talk about Grandpa's music. I told you, I will be there Monday. Why didn't I ever get a chance to see any Grandpa songs?
I never got around to it.
For 25 years, you never got around to it? Come on, Dad! I'm sure there was one evening in those 25 years you could have showed me.
Jason, that has nothing
Dad,
to do
with... Dad, why don't you ever play your clarinet for me? 25 years I've never heard you play. That's kind of crazy, isn't it? I mean, if I had a son, I think I'd at least play my guitar for him. Once.
I'm going home. Please be there on Monday.
I will.
I just want you to be somebody, son.
I'll be somebody, Dad. I'll be somebody.
Good night. Get some rest.
I'll be somebody, Dad. I'll be somebody.
The word free. It came with the free. Teddy, please.
You can sing one to yourself if you like.
Sure, please. It's your first song called
television screen, wondering if this day was worth watching.
feet were frozen to the floor. I made a final lunge and sprang up to the door. Then I rushed outside to get some air.
Thank you.
Mom, do you know who Emerson was?
He was a poet.
I must be myself. I can no longer break myself for you. If you can love me for who I am, we shall be the happier. Miles is bringing this to me, Lou. Mom, do you have a dream? I have to know. Did you ever have a dream?
What? Why are you asking me that?
When you were a little girl, did you ever wonder about things?
What kind
of things? The sun, the moon, the stars.
Well, yeah, I'm sure I did. I can't recall, Jason. I remember a giant oak tree and a swing that my father made for me. I'd sit in that swing for hours and just watch the clouds passing overhead. For a long time, I thought they were there just for me. And there were poplar trees that surrounded the farm. Oh, how they glistened in the summer. And in the autumn, I'd sit in that swing and I'd look at all the beautiful and brilliant colors of the season, the reds and the golds and the fashion. I used to dream of designing clothes that reflected how I felt about that beautiful season. I hadn't thought of that since I was a very little girl, Jason, all those years now.
Did you know what your mom and dad's dream was?
No. I suppose they lived there the day of their lives. I never had to ask. They were farmers. They loved the land that they harvested. They worked long, hard hours, and they had very little to show for it. But I always believed that they were the richest people in the world. Your grandparents were happy. They had hard times, like so many of us do. But I truly believe that they were the happiest people I ever knew. Sometimes I miss that happiness. I miss it purely.
Make me something, Mom. An autumn design. I love the fall.
I will.
I write songs.
Yes, you do.
You know, Mom, nothing matters. Nothing matters. All the effort, all the self-deceit, all those steps to the top. Nothing matters except your dream. And sharing that dream with others. I was always afraid to be myself. I thought being me was wrong. I thought if I showed myself to my bosses, my teachers, my family, it was wrong. It's not wrong, is it, Mom?
Jason, I always taught you to be yourself.
I don't know what happened.
You learned what growing up is all about.
I must be myself. He was the only friend I ever had.
I know that.
It was crazy. Last night, we were singing Christmas songs. You should have seen him. He was playing the bells. You should have seen his face when Dad walked in. He didn't know whether to drop the bells and run or keep on singing. Well, he kept on playing those bells, and you know what he said? He said, Merry Christmas, Mr. Miller. He said, Merry Christmas. Why?
I know I got all these.
Jason, he decided he had to give it up.
and he always felt that the further away he stayed from telling me the truth about his past, the better off he'd be. Oh, Jason, he does love you. He may not show it in the ways you need him to, but he loves you, and he would never do anything to hurt you.
I believe you, Mom. Mom?
Can dreams be real?
Oh, yes, Jason.
Dreams can be real.
I love this beautiful earth. I love the people on it. I love you.
guess I better run along.
Okay.
Son, I always wanted to be in your world. I was once. So I got scared and gave up. Your grandfather was one hell of a good folk singer. You know, I remember the first time he took me to hear him play. It was at a county fair. All the songs he sang were original. He never would play anybody else's tunes. If somebody requested one, he'd say, "Well, I would, but Jason Miller only plays Jason Miller." And it was true. Oh, he liked to listen to other kinds of music, but he never would play any of them, only his own. I used to stop the people that passed by and I'd say, "See that man up there singing? That's my dad. He's going to be rich someday."
What happened?
Well, my mom left, took me with her. I don't know, except somewhere along the way, the bottle became more important than his guitar. Or maybe being around others that drank made him more susceptible to it. There probably wasn't any cause, but in those days, they didn't look on alcoholism as a disease. But drunk or sober, he loved playing more than anything in the world. You know, he told me once that a song brought him closer to his maker. And without a song, it was just emptiness. It's funny, but I miss him now more than anything in the world.
What about you? What about your band? What about your music? Do you miss playing in those clubs?
Sit down. Your old man. Your old man was the best licorice blower the south side of Chicago ever heard. I dared others to play better. There was a period there when we played 7 days a week and they couldn't get enough of us. Money was good, tips were better, food was great. Some people even told me I played better than Goodman. Now, that was the ultimate compliment then. They might not have had it, but it sounded good at the time. Well, your mother, she used to come, she'd bring her knitting. She'd sit in the corner over there with a ginger ale, just smile. Smile like an angel. I used to show off for him by laying on my back and playing. Well, we played about midnight. By then, she'd be sound asleep in that corner. Still holding that beautiful smile. I'll never forget those wonderful memories. Go after your dream, son. Don't let it die. But on one condition, the immortal words of Sir Winston Churchill, never, never give up. Never, never give up. Friends?
Dad?
Yes.
Can dreams be real?
That they can.
Thank you. Thank you.
He was a warm old man, warmer than I. He was a strong old man, stronger than I. He said,
say